and welcome to episode 5 of Upbeat. Were any of y'all out Pokemoning over the weekend for the 20th anniversary?
I personally was not. I was watching the Golden Globes because I love the magic of movies and TV, and I really felt that magic last night. There were a lot of amazing nominations and award winners. It was just awesome. Ashley, what were you doing?
Oh, I was definitely out Pokemoning. I have so been taking advantage of these events to level up my character. So excited for the 25th anniversary. But in the meantime, I am a little interested about what's happening with the COVID relief package on the Hill, especially now that we're heading up to a year since COVID-19 has really hit the U.S.
In the recent months, the House of Representatives have been meeting to discuss Biden's $1.9 trillion stimulus relief bill.
Yes, this bill is called the American Rescue Plan Act, and it was passed early this Saturday, but now it faces an uphill battle in the Senate.
We have no time to waste. If we act now, decisively, quickly, and boldly, we can finally get ahead of this virus.
This stimulus package is expected to help those that are unemployed, hungry, uninsured, or own small businesses. Each person who is unemployed would get $400 a week in federal unemployment money until August 29th. That's an increase of $300 a week from what those who are unemployed are getting now. Those who are eligible would get a one-time payment of $1,400, which is $200 more than the first stimulus check.
We need to relieve that suffering. The American Rescue Plan does just that. It relieves the suffering, and it's time to act.
Families with children are eligible to get an additional $1,400 for each dependent. Unlike the previous two stimulus packages, adult dependents, including college students, would be eligible for one-time payments.
So many of them were shut out because they were older than 17. And many parents are taking care of disabled adult children, and they are also in need.
A provision added to the bill of a minimum wage increase to $15 by 2025 is expected to be voted out by Republicans in the Senate.
In the House, no Republicans voted for the bill, and two Democratic officials voted against it. The bill passed through the House with a 7-vote majority. Republicans' biggest opposition to the bill is the size of the package. They want a much smaller check offered to each group, much like President Trump's first stimulus package.
It goes straight into addressing food insecurity. It goes straight into assisting our schools and our first responders and coordinating with hospitals. It goes straight into putting needles into arms. I mean, these are basic services. This is what's keeping people from having their utilities turned off.
In order to push the legislation through the Senate, the bill will need the support of every Democrat and independent in the 100-seat chamber. Vice President Kamala Harris' tie-breaking vote in the Senate gives Democrats a slight edge, but any refusal to fully tie the party line on the bill could prove fatal to its chances of being passed into law. After going through the Senate, the bill will go back to the House for a second vote before going to President Biden.
Representatives want this bill to be on Biden's desk before unemployment benefits expire on March 14th.
The bill will be sent to the Senate for voting this week.
This weekend, the big screen was center stage. It was the start of award season with the 78th annual Golden Globes. Having nominees and hosts remote into the show came with its own technical difficulties. Some for laughs, and others that made us cringe.
Now, Tina and I are hosting from two different cities tonight, but the technology is so great, you are never going to be able to tell the difference. It's going to be smooth sailing.
You won't even notice.
I wish I could hear.
For those of you who couldn't tell, that was actor Daniel Kaluuya accidentally on mute for his acceptance speech as he won Best Supporting Actor in a Motion Picture for his role in Judas and the Black Messiah. And some things were mispronounced.
Sounds.
In general, movies have had a hard year in theaters due to the pandemic, which explains why Netflix single-handedly received 42 nominations. While Netflix's Mank had the most nominations at 6, they didn't win any of their categories. Chloe Zhao becomes the second woman to win Best Director in the Golden Globes history, and the first woman of color. Her film Nomadland also won Best Drama Film.
Now this is why I fell in love with making movies and telling stories, because it gave us a chance to laugh and cry together. And it gave us a chance to learn from each other and to have more compassion for each other, so thank you.
And Chadwick Boseman posthumously received a Golden Globe for Best Actor in a Drama Motion Picture for his role in Ma Rainey's Black Bottom.
Don't give me a band and make me some records.
And in the realm of TV, The Crown won big time with awards for Best Actress in a Television Series, Actor in a Television Series, Best Drama Television Series, and Best Television Supporting Actress. Other winners for TV were The Queen's Gambit, Ted Lasso, and Schitt's Creek. To find out if your favorite movie or show won, you can see all the nominations, winners, and speeches at goldenglobes.com.
Pop star Taylor Swift is countersuing Evermore Park, an amusement park in Pleasant Grove. The countersuit comes after the park filed a claim against her earlier this month for trademark infringement by her latest album, Evermore. This week, Swift's management team filed a counterclaim against Evermore Park, alleging that the park violated copyright laws by performing Swift songs such as Love Story and You Belong With Me without proper licensing or permission since 2018. Earlier this month, Evermore Park, a fantasy world themed park, sued Taylor Swift, her management company, and her merchandising company, known as Taylor Nation, for a percentage of the profits from her latest album, Evermore, for what they claim is trademark infringement. Swift released Evermore in December after spending her time in quarantine writing the songs.
So we basically just couldn't stop writing, and I am absolutely elated to be able to share it with you tonight.
After the album release, web traffic on Evermore Park's site dramatically increased, but they say that Swift's Evermore merchandise negatively affected their own merchandise sales and caused confusion for park guests.
Be so clever, you forget to be kind.
The park is demanding $2 million in damages. Swift's legal team has called these allegations baseless. Broadcast Music Incorporated, a performing rights organization that protects artists and collects revenue for their work, says they have attempted to contact Evermore Park for more than a year with music license agreements for the songs they have been using illegally. Swift's lawsuit claims that the park ignored these notices and has only recently asked the organization to license previous performances as legal litigation approached. The park is also reportedly using songs from other artists, such as Katy Perry, The Beatles, and Queen, without legal permission to do so. Evermore Park has not yet responded to a request for comment regarding the lawsuit. If you would have looked online only a week ago, Evermore Park had several videos that included clips of Taylor's songs. Now, they've all disappeared.
This year, Pokémon celebrates their 25th anniversary. Pokémon creators hope the year-long celebration of virtual events and new releases will be so enticing, you gotta catch them all. In 1996, Pokemon creator Tajiri Satoshi and art director Ken Sugimori had a simple Game Boy concept. Players would travel through a fictional world capturing and training creatures.
An astounding 25 years have passed since the Pokemon series was born. We've shared so much with you over the past 25 years, through our games, but also through so many other mediums, thanks to the support you've all shown us.
The Pokemon Company plans on celebrating their anniversary on an equally global scale. February 27th is the official Pokemon Day, but you can expect celebrations to be held throughout the whole year. One of the first P25 events was a virtual concert headlined by Post Malone at 25.pokemon.com.
I never would have guessed we would be here today, after 25 years.
Post Malone previewed one of the many songs to be released on the Pokemon 25 Anniversary album, available for pre-save on Spotify. Their anniversary website features updates on other artists like J Balvin, expected to be on the P25 album, in addition to a list of promotions available each month. Through March 8th, select McDonald's locations are offering Pokemon trading cards in their Happy Meals. Pokemon Headquarters continues to release new games.
Welcome to the world of new Pokemon Snap!
Their latest game, Pokemon Snap, is set to release on April 30th. The Photo Safari game is a Nintendo Switch modernization of their popular Nintendo 64 game. Existing games aren't missing out on the fun. Pokemon Headquarters is holding special events in games like Pokemon Sword, Pokemon Shield, Pokemon Cafe Mix, and Pokemon Go. And new events will begin each month of the calendar year. The Pokémon Celebration will continue to be highly effective. You can keep up with all the news and virtual events for the year by visiting the anniversary website 25.pokemon.com.
Thanks for tuning in for this episode of Upbeat.
Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok.
Have a great day. See you next Monday.